My name is Shane Avery, and welcome to my video tutorial series. The name of the series is CouchDB and ext.js4, a winning Web 2.0 app combination. We're going to focus in on our first tutorial, which is entitled Getting Started with CouchDB. And some objectives we're going to achieve are this. We're going to demonstrate how easy it is to set up CouchDB and get it working and usable on your local computer, as well as how to set up CouchDB in the cloud, so to speak, using a free service called CouchApp. We're also going to demonstrate how to set up and use CouchApp that allows you to publish JavaScript applications to any CouchDB anywhere you have access. We're also going to highlight some features of Futon, which is the CouchDB administration utility that ships with Couch. And finally, we're going to highlight the JSON data structure of a CouchDB document. So let's get started by first showing you how to install CouchDB on your local computer. So the first thing you need to do is open up a browser. And if you go to couchbase.com, Couchbase is the organization that is actively developing CouchDB, and they're the commercial organization on the front end of this project. And right off their homepage, they have a nice download button. So if you go there, it'll take you to a page that shows you the different editions. We're just going to download Couchbase Single Server, the Community Edition. So we'll click this button here. Takes us to a little page where we can join a community if we'd like to, or if you just want to skip all that and not join the community, you can just click this link here, and we'll just go straight to the download page. And it runs on Linux, Mac OS 10, and Windows. And since I'm using Windows 7 is my development platform, I'll be downloading the 32-bit Windows version of CouchDB here. And just like any Windows user is used to, if you double-click this, a very convenient install shield wizard will run and take you through the steps to install and set up CouchDB. And that's it, really. You're just about done as far as setting up your whole back end, because CouchDB is more than just a database server. It's also a web server. It's an application server. It's very robust. It basically represents, depending on what you're trying to do, your whole back end. And certainly for our example application that we're going to build, this is all that's necessary. Now, once you install and run Couchbase server, because it has its own web server, you'll be able to access it through a browser. So if you point your browser to this URL, localhost:5984_utils, you'll get a glimpse of Futon, which is a nice web application that lets you administer CouchDB. After you get familiar with CouchDB and how it works, this gets you on the fast track. You can start developing right away. And that's one of the great advantages of using CouchDB. But what if you need to test CouchDB live on the internet? What if you want other users outside your LAN to access your CouchDB, your application or your data? You have to set up your own web host and install Couch on that and do all the rigmarole to get going with CouchDB on a dedicated server somewhere or on some virtual host. Fortunately, no, you don't, thanks to a free service called CouchApp, which offers CouchDB hosting for free live on the internet. So briefly, I'll show you how to set that up. It's just a wonderful testing tool for development, because I don't have to hassle with setting these things up on my own server, and it's free, so you can't lose. So after going to iriscouch.com's homepage, just click this Sign Up Now button. Just fill out these four fields, and when you hit this Send button, instantly you'll have your own CouchDB in the cloud. And so I did that already, and this is my URL, dshaneavery.iriscouch.com. So before we take a tour of Futon here in the Iris Couch, let's talk about CouchApp. What is a CouchApp? Well, basically, it's a JavaScript and HTML application that serve directly from CouchDB. So if we're going to write a JavaScript application served directly out of Couch, we're going to need a tool to get our files, our JavaScript files, our HTML files, or all our other resources into CouchDB. And so that's what the CouchApp command line utility program does for us. And since we're using ESTJS4, our entire application is written in JavaScript. So it works out real well. So to get it, you go to couchapp.org. And they have an installing page. And you can install this utility on Linux or Mac OS X. But again, we're using Windows in this example, so I'll download a standalone executable for Windows. The version I've downloaded is 0.8.1 here. And it comes again with a nice installer executable. You double-click that and run through the wizard using the default settings. You can install CouchApp. I've already done so, so we don't need to do that. I'll just cancel out of that. And once you're finished, you'll be able to access CouchApp right from your command line. Type in CouchApp. And a little bit later, we'll show you how to use it to publish your our Couch app, the MVC Couch application that we're going to create. So let's get back to featuring Futon, which again is CouchDB's administration tool. So the first thing we need to do is create an admin. You'll notice when you first look at your instance of Iris Couch here, everyone is an admin. But right now, this is very insecure. Anyone who finds this website can basically take control of your Couch instance, and that's probably not what you want. So you just click this Fix This link, and it lets you create a username and a password, which I will do. Now you can see I'm logged in as Shane, I'm an admin, and now no one can write to this instance of CouchDB. No one can create new databases, no one can delete any databases, and so forth. Only I can. However, the general public can still read from this Futon interface, which I find helpful when I'm collaborating with other developers and I want to show them what's going on in the back end. They can still see it. I think it's actually a good thing for testing and developing your application. The next thing we need to do is create a database for our MVC Couch application. And that's very simple to do also. We just click Create Database. And we need to name our database MVC Couch, which I've done in all lowercase. And you'll have to remember that for later. That's going to become part of the URI for our database. But for now, we'll just type in that name and create the database. And now we have a place to put all our documents. So really, what is a CouchDB database? For simplicity's sake, I like to just view a single database in CouchDB as a single table with only one column. And in that one column, you can have an infinite number of rows. And each row in the column is a document. That's all a CouchDB database is a stack of documents. So let's go ahead and look inside of MVC Couch. Once you create it, you're given some new options here. And let's create a new document and see what that looks like. You'll notice that CouchDB automatically, by default, will give you an underscore ID field. And this will always, this has to exist on every document. And of course, this is what it uniquely identifies the documents. And by default, CouchDB uses GUIDs, string of characters that will most likely never be duplicated anywhere on any computer, to guarantee the uniqueness of this particular document. And so you have a nice field view of a new document here. You can also look at the source view, which shows you the JSON structure here. And if you double-click, you can edit the JSON structure here. So all documents in CouchDB are stored as JSON, which is, of course, JavaScript object notation. And that's really cool for object-oriented programmers who are already familiar with objects, because the data is stored natively as an object. And of course, application developers who are used to that know what to do with objects in their application code. So as long as it's valid JSON, CouchDB will save your document. And that's great. If you wanted to do your documents, store simple key-value pairs. JSON supports that. If you want to store arrays, you can do that. You can have as many fields in your document as you want, or properties, as some people call them. You can have arrays of objects. You can have objects. You can have nested JSON. You can have arrays of objects that are nested within another object, its property, and so forth. So you can have a very simple schema or very complex schema per document, and Couch will save it. And that's another thing that's attractive about CouchDB, is that it's schemaless. It does not enforce any schema. It's up to you, the application developer, how you want to define and relate to your documents. So that's a little discussion on JSON. Getting back to Futon, you can use a few tools here. You can upload attachments and add fields right here in the Futon interface, which is good for maybe testing and fooling around with document modeling. And it's a full-on editor, so you can play with that if you want to. We're not going to spend much time with that. In fact, let's go ahead and just delete this field I just made, and go ahead and save this document, because I want to show you another required field that CouchDB enforces on all documents, and that's this underscore rev field. All documents, after they've been saved, will get one of these, and this is how it tracks the version of the document, so that it can achieve eventual consistency. I wanted to show you the JSON structure for documents that we're going to use for our application, mvcCouch. So I'll switch back to my local instance of CouchDB, which is Couch-based server. And here's the local version of mvcCouch that I created earlier. Let's look at that. And let's just look at one of the documents that's already stored there. Here's the JSON structure for that. So as you can see, our application is going to be storing JSON a little bit more complex than just some keys and values off the root of the object. We're going to be using this members property, which is an array of objects. So this outer JSON will kind of represent user groups, but this inner array of JSON will represent individual users that belong to this user group. So this structure is kind of just to demonstrate maybe a master detail document model, maybe something that you would use. I wanted to show something a little more than just basic key value pairs off the root, because this is going to show off the new associations feature of AXTJS4's data package, and how you can even use that with document databases. You can use it just as well with them as you can with a relational database. So that's it for part one of our series. I hope I didn't ramble on too much. I look forward to seeing you for the next tutorial.